castanet part from Debussy's Iberia offers an opportunity to explore technique, phrasing, and style on an instrument not often used in the orchestra, and therefore not often practiced by classical percussionists. Today, I'll share my approach with you with the goal of achieving a very precise but highly musical performance that captures the spirit of this colorful music. First off, I think we should use the style of these Spanish melodies to inform the rhythmic interpretation of the triplet figures throughout this part. This means we should actually try to compress the triplet and give it direction towards the downbeats. It helps to repeat this figure like an exercise when you practice it to ingrain the feel of this style. I like to flam many of the eighth notes in this part in order to evoke the sound of a flamenco castanet player. It can be a fairly open flam, and the grace note is only slightly softer than the main note. For the very soft passages at rehearsal 12 and at the end of the movement, I just play single notes instead of flams in order to create the quietest dynamic possible. Another way that I like to evoke the sound of flamenco castanets is to play directly on a second mounted pair of castanets for a few of the louder moments in this movement. Some of the notes are marked with rooftop accents. Doubling up the castanet sound in this way not only gives us added volume, but also the illusion of multiple players playing in unison. Finally, pay close attention to the section from rehearsal 3 to 4. These figures are typically played as a redoble roll, where each stroke has a rebound. This makes the sound more full, like a double stroke roll. I place one finger on the top of each castanet and used a wrist stroke to create this effect. But the dynamic is piano, so you have to be careful not to let this new technique increase the volume. I flam the downbeats and then play an upstroke on a different spot on my knee in order to create the staccato release of each roll as it's written. This helps match the placement and color of the tambourine part, which is also sounding on the third eighth note. Immediately at rehearsal 4, I take my finger off the castanets so that I can play the forte rhythms that follow. There are many effective ways to play this part, so I offer my approach as just one possibility. I hope it gives you some inspiration and ideas to take into your practicing and preparation when you have the chance to play this piece in the orchestra. So to wrap up, I'll leave you with my performance of the first movement of Debussy's Iberia from the beginning to rehearsal 12.